Bonjour mes chers amis et bienvenue à cet nouvel épisode de Franglish. Hello everyone, and today's lesson is how to talk about yourself, okay? So today we are going to learn how to write a paragraph in French to talk about yourself, starting from introduction, your favorite sport, what do you like to do in your free time, and more. I have divided this lesson into 9 parts, which means that today you are going to learn how to write 9 full sentences in French to introduce yourself or to talk about yourself. Number 1 is how to greet. Number 2 is how to say your name. Number 3 is how to say how old are you with your date of birth. Number 4 is how to say where do you live by giving us your address. And number 5 is how to say, what is your nationality? 6, which school you go into, and you will talk to us about your favorite subjects and favorite teachers. On 7, you will talk to us about your favorite sport. 8, you will tell us what do you like to do in your free time. And in the last sentence, number 9, you will just give us your information like phone number and email. I have posted previously a video showing you guys how to build a conversation to introduce yourself and how to ask people what's their names, age, nationality, and more. I put the link in the description if you want to check it out. For students, don't forget to subscribe to this channel to learn more French, and for teachers to get some lesson plans and teaching tips with some project ideas. We go directly to part 1, which is greeting, okay? So in French, we have different ways to greet, okay? We will just talk about 3 main ones that we use every time. The first one is bonjour, which means good morning. Bonsoir, which means good afternoon or good evening. And we have the last one, which is salut, which means hi or hello. Some people also use bonjour as a hello. So when you start writing a paragraph about yourself, like introducing yourself or talking about yourself, it's better to start with one of these, like bonjour, bonsoir, or salut. Then you say your name and you keep going. Let's go to the second sentence now. The second sentence is how you're going to say my name is. In French, to say your name, you just use the expression je m'appelle, then you add your name, okay? So you say je m'appelle, you can put your first name, or you can say je m'appelle and you put first and last name. In the third part, we will learn how to say how old are you, okay? And in this part also, I want to add something, which is how you're gonna say I was born, then you put your date of birth. So to say how old are you in French, it's not like English. You be careful, guys. You do not say I am 20 years old or I am 15 years old, but you say I have, okay? So I am in French is je suis, and I have in French is j'ai. So you do not say je suis 15 ans, but you say j'ai 15 ans. In French, you have to say j'ai, you use to have, not to be, to say your age. Then make sure also you add en after the number, okay? So en means years old, and you don't pronounce the S at the end. So you don't say j'ai 16 ans. No, you just say j'ai 16 ans. The S at the end is silent, okay? And also try to add that every time you say your age, okay? So it's more appropriate to say I have 16 years old rather than just saying I have 16. In English, for example, when someone tells you how old are you, if you are 15, you can say I am 15 years old, or you can say I am 15. But in French, it's much better if you add the years old after the number. So you can make this sentence also longer by adding your date of birth, okay? By saying, je suis né le and you put your date of birth, okay? For example, you say, je suis né le 5 janvier 2003. I was born on January 5th, 2003. And né here has the accent, and if you are masculine, you use né, masculine. If you are feminine, you use né, feminine, which means you add an E. Let's go part now is how you're gonna say, where do you live? We're gonna use the expression j'habite or le verbe j'habite, I live, okay? So you say, I live, j'habite, à, okay? So you put à with the accent, then the name of the city. So you say, j'habite à Paris, j'habite à New York. And you can also add some more expressions to make the sentence more beautiful, okay? So using avec mes parents, for example, you say, I live in Paris with my parents. J'habite à Paris avec mes parents. I live in Paris with my grandma. So you say, j'habite à Paris avec ma grand-mère. Or you can say, I live in Paris with my brother. J'habite à Paris avec mon frère. And I want to add an extension to this sentence is you say your address. You add your address to this sentence. So by saying mon adresse est, and you put your address, okay? So for the address, guys, you can write it in English if you want to, okay? So it doesn't matter if your address is in English or you live in England or United States. So you can write your address in English. The next sentence now, guys, is how do you say what is your nationality? I have already talked about it in previous videos. So here you just use the expression je suis, I am, okay? Plus the nationality. You say, I am American, you say, je suis américain. For masculine, you say, je suis américain. For feminine, you say, je suis américaine. You add an E to the feminine. So here I have some adjectives of nationality. If you want to use them, we have the masculine and the feminine form. So if you are masculine, you just use the masculine adjective of nationality. If you are feminine, you just use the feminine form of the adjective of nationality. Let's go now to part is how do you say which school you're going to? I just want to add something quickly before we start this part is schools are named differently in French-speaking countries, okay? So in French-speaking countries or in France, elementary school is called école primaire, middle school is called le collège, high school is called le lycée, okay? So here we're gonna make it very simple. You just say, I am a student at, you put the name of your school, okay? So if you go in, for example, to Victor Hugo High School, or you are a student at Victor Hugo High School, you just say, je suis étudiant au lycée Victor Hugo. If you go into Riverside High School, you say, je suis étudiant au lycée Riverside, okay? And here, guys, we have étudiant is a noun, okay? So if you are masculine, you can use étudiant, but if you are feminine, you be careful. You need to add an E to étudiant, which makes it étudiant. So you will need to say, je suis étudiante au lycée Riverside, or je suis étudiante au lycée Victor Hugo. And in this part also, I want to add an extension. So I want you guys to say what are your favorite subjects, okay? If you have one favorite subject, you can say ma matière préférée est, and you put the name of the subject. If you have more than one favorite subject, so you have many favorite subjects in your school, you can just say mes matières préférées sont, and you put the favorite subjects. So if you have only one favorite subject, you will say ma matière préférée est la musique. If you have more than one favorite subject, you can say mes matières préférées sont les maths, la biologie et la musique. I made you guys this list of subjects that you can look at, okay? Basically the subjects that students take in the United States schools. So you can use them to tell me what are your favorite subjects at the end of this lesson. Next part, guys, is what is your favorite sport? So you can write the sentence however you want it. So you can say, for example, mon sport préféré est le football, or mon sport préféré est le basketball, mon sport préféré est le baseball, or you can say mon sport favori est le football, mon sport favori est le basketball, and mon sport favori est le baseball. You can also add an extension to this sentence by saying, for example, I am in the school team. Je suis dans l'équipe de l'école. So the full sentence will be something like, j'aime tous les sports. Mon sport favori est le football. Je suis dans l'équipe du lycée. That means, I like all the sports. My favorite sport is soccer. And I am in the school soccer team. Let's go to part number 8 now. So in this part, guys, you are going to learn how you're going to say what do you like to do in your free time. So in this part here, guys, we will try to start our sentences by using the expression j'aime, which means I like. So for example, if you like to listen to music in your free time, so you will say j'aime écouter la musique. And always, guys, as I said it before, try to add an extension to your sentences to make them beautiful. By saying, for example, in my free time, I like to listen to music. My favorite singer is, or you can say, my favorite song is, okay? So you can say, for example, j'aime écouter la musique. Ma chanson préférée est, and you put the name of the song, de, and you put the singer. J'aime écouter la musique. Ma chanson préférée est Black or White de Michael Jackson. So you say, ma chanson préférée est, the title of the song, de, the name of the singer. And if you like to read in your free time, you can say, j'aime lire. Mon livre préféré est White Fang de Jack London, which translates into I like to read and my favorite book is White Fang of Jack London. And the last example, if you like to watch movies, you say j'aime regarder les films, or you can even say j'aime regarder Netflix. J'aime regarder YouTube. And like I said, you can just add an extension. You say, I like to watch movies and my favorite actor is, my favorite actress is, my favorite movie is, okay? Is how to give someone your contact information or how to write your contact information. It's very simple also. You just say, pour me contacter, mon numéro de téléphone est, my phone number is, and you put your phone number. Mon email est, my email is, and you put your email. Let's go to practice now, okay? So I have an activity for you guys. So you will write a paragraph about yourself, including all the parts that we have seen during this lesson, starting from your name, age, date of birth, all the way to your contact information. So look to the samples that I have here, guys, for you, okay? So you can choose to make the paper landscape or portrait, okay? It's up to you guys. You put your picture in the corner and you start writing the paragraph. Use some colors and pictures to illustrate your paper. For example, if you like to play guitar, you can put a picture of a guitar. If you like to play soccer, you can put a picture of a soccer ball or anything like that. So when you finish preparing this card, you will present it first to the class, then I will collect them and put them in your personal folders. So you have 1 week to do that. Make sure you bring that with you next week so you can present it to class before you give it to me. Merci de suivre, mes chers amis, et n'oubliez pas de vous abonner à la chaîne. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to watch more videos related to learning French, ESL, and immigration support. Bonne chance tout le monde. Au revoir, à la prochaine.